welcome to my channel, Kimbaskrafts. My name is Kim, and if this is your first time clicking on one of my videos to check it out, I hope you enjoy what you hear and see. And if you're returning from a previous video, as always, I appreciate your continued support. We are here for my fourth installment of this huge, massive kit up. Moogie settling in. it's nighttime, and I'm a little schleppy, but I really want to get this done, guys. It is Wednesday night. So, you know, I have not had a chance to sit down and do more of this since I completed the third box. You okay? Okay. So, we're gonna do box four, and I'm hoping five tonight. So what I like, first thing I want to do is, so I'm hoping to keep this in five boxes. I'm using this style of box. If you haven't seen any of the kit up videos yet, or if you don't plan on watching any of the other ones, this is the kit up. These are the boxes that I've chosen to use. And there are 56 of these little pods in a box. And I have a five pack. So I was hoping to keep it to a five pack. I have like 20 of these. So I have plenty if I go over five. However, I really don't want to. I've worked with five in the past and I'd like to stick with five. It's very manageable and, you know, it's what I'm used to and I really don't want to go over that if I don't need to. So I'm just gonna do a real quick count. So if there's 56 in each box and I want to only use two more boxes, that's 112. And then I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 20, 28, and that's 29. And then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 38, 46, 54. This is 92. So yeah, less than 112. Perfect. Okay. Just want to make sure I had enough boxes. That's all. I have to recap for myself because I don't remember now. 3rd box, we left off at 939. Okay, so we are still in the 900s. So we were not able to package all the 900s. That's fine. Okay, and then, all right. So the first one we have is 943. All right, so here's my box. Let's go ahead and make our labels first. I kind of like the way that worked for me. I hope everybody's having a good day, a good week. We are in right now. You're not going to see this on Wednesday. I still have the third video to edit and then put up. My nails are still on. So I explained that I actually did these. This is the only chipping that I've had so far that happened today. I did some here's another little chip. I did some like massive cleaning with Clorox today, scrubbing a lot of things. laundry, bathrooms, floors, all kinds of things. So yeah, that's where I know that's when it got messed up. So all right, so 943 and 958, and neither one of them need a star. And then I need 959, 959, and 961 get a star each. And then it's 966 with a star. And then 995, no star. 996, no star. And it's going to share a row with 3012 with a star. And then we're going to have 3031 with a star, and 3328, and 3350 and then I'm going to go ahead and give I'm going to do 3350. That's, and then 3363. I'm going to go ahead and give that three boxes. All right. So let's start with that. All right. So my belly is kind of upset right now. And what do I have in front of me? Of course, I have coffee. But yeah, my belly's a little upset. Been drinking a lot of water, but I was in the mood for, well, I put collagen in my coffee and I got my witch's brew cup, and it does look like witch's brew, I guess. Okay. So we start at the top and I go down and then go down. So let's find 943. I don't know where. I don't know where the 940s are. 38. This is 11. So this is 10. 30s. Okay. What did you do now? 995, 996. Okay, what am I looking for? 943. Okay, there you are. This is 943, and I guess we're gonna need two. All right. Let's see. Yeah, so I obviously was not able to come back to this as much as I wanted to. Oh God, Kim, really? Is that how we're starting this video off? Oh man, bad news bears. I could have worked on this, but I really wanted to do some diamond painting, and honestly, I can't record and edit at the same time. So I was like, you know what? I have all this footage. Let me get some editing done. Let me get a video up, because it's been a minute. So that's what I decided to do. While I diamond painted, I went ahead and edited those two videos. And there's some static in here. And so that's why I didn't get to do more of this. Last night, Bob and I rented Deadpool and Wolverine, and we watched that together. And then, surprisingly, I really thought I was going to be out for the count, because I was trying not to fall asleep during the movie. And, somehow I was able to stay up late last night. I stayed up till like midnight. All I did was diamond paint. So, all right, we do not need a star for this one. 943 with no star. Let me see. Let me cross that off. 943 we did. 958. That's all 958. Very similar in colors. And again, I won't need a star. So I got my third row done on my crystal canvas art designs, and I did post a picture of it on IG. And I have to tell you guys, I'm really, really, really enjoying that canvas. And I don't think I told you guys, but I have really been good about spending money. I have not purchased a canvas since May. Yes, I have not purchased a canvas from any company since May. There's so many companies that I would love to try. I really cannot justify to spend it on a diamond painting at this point. There's so many shops that I would love to try. But there's shops that I have that I haven't tried yet. Still, you know, so I just trying to keep everything in perspective. All right, so 959, and be a responsible adult, and you know when to say no. But I have to tell you, I have so many videos to make, and it's just been, you know, I mean, obviously I just started this project, and this project is, all right, so we're going to save this one. No, once I started the kit up, now I have to finish it. But today I got up, Bob and I, oh my gosh, guys, we slept late. We slept till almost 9 o'clock, and this dog did not wake us up. She slept in the bed with us till 9 o'clock. She didn't wake us up to go to the bathroom, to eat, nothing. And then when we got up out of bed, like, oh my God, how did you let us sleep so late? She's like laying on the bedroom floor for kisses and hugs and pets and stuff. It was crazy. Like, we got up and she like climbed down the bed, and then we're like petting her and kissing her, and she's just like laying there. I was like, don't you have to, go OUT, don't you have to go OUT? And she's like rolling over. I mean, everybody was tired. So I had a late start to the day, just as it was. So Bob took her to where he goes in the neighborhood to run her. And I cleaned, guys. I cleaned. I stripped our bed. I washed all of our bedding, all of our comforters and our blankets, and changed our sheets and bleached the bathroom. Vacuumed everything, did laundry, put all the clean clothes away, went through the closet a little bit to like you know how your closet'll get messed up if you're just throwing things in there and stuff. So straightened up the closet, hung things up that should have been hung up that weren't, and did more of a deep clean, I feel like. And then when he got home, I got ready and I left, went to the gym. And then I went to the gym. These have a lot of static, these little bags. I gotta, like, they're sticking to my fingers. That's why I had to cut them apart. Went to the gym and then came home. I ate and then I grabbed the dog and I took her to the D-O-G-P-A-R-K, and sorry, this is okay. All right, I had to get a new dryer sheet. Let me get a square in there because that's bad. Shake it around. I probably should put one in this one too. Yeah, and then as I'm like, when I was getting ready to leave, my son called me and he was like, "Oh, do you want to meet for dinner?" And I was like, "Well, I have the dog. Like, I don't know, like, what would I do with her?" And she's got to eat. And honestly, I picked up food to make turkey burgers. Actually, not turkey burgers. I picked up food to make chicken burgers. I've never made chicken burgers before. But the last time I was in the supermarket, this older guy was like, "This is $9.96. $9.66 is this one." Okay. He was like, "Oh, the ground chicken has a really good price if you don't mind ground chicken." And it was 2 pounds. If you looked at by the unit, it was like $3.99 a pound. So I remembered that and I'm looking at it and I'm like, I think a chicken burger is not bad, because all the turkey was like seven something a pound. So for almost half the price, or actually for more than half the price, you know, I was able to get 2 pounds. So I'm like, sold. Chicken burgers it is. And this is what I've been craving. And it was so good, guys. it's on a broche. You get a broche bun and you, in this case, chicken burgers, but normally it's turkey burgers. And goat cheese with some fig jam and some spring mix. So easy, and it's so flavorful. And my son was like, this is so good. I said, I'm so glad he came over. I'm like, what would you have eaten if you went home? And he's like, probably a DiGiorno. I'm like, I'm so glad you came over. And yeah, it was so good. I love that combination, goat cheese and fig jam. If you've never had it, I highly recommend. And then we had a donut for dessert. And he and I have been watching this anime every time he comes over. It's called Spy Family X. And it's so cute. All right, now this is 966. So I have 960. Wait a minute. Oh, what did I do? What was this? Oh, this was 966. What am I doing? All right, so I had 943 and 950, 959 and 961. Oh, this is 961. All right, it's okay. Whew. Sorry, guys. I'm like, what the heck am I doing? And this poured out pretty nicely, and of course I ruined it. Oh, see, not so bad. So, I feel like off. All right, let's get this in here. Obviously I'm off. And this is garbage. Little nub. There is a, yeah, there's a dryer sheet in there. All right. This calls for four. And it calls for exactly four, so I don't need a star on it. This is 966. I mean, there's a little static, but it's very minimum. Put this one in here. Spy Family. It's so cute. I like anime, but I don't watch it unless it's with my son, because it's not something that you can diamond paint and watch. It's, you know, it's in Japanese and you have to read subtitles. So I don't watch that often because I never really sit down and watch TV. Now the other night I went out into the kitchen and I was eating and I felt like turning on the TV, and I just happened to turn on Netflix. I was like, let me see if I can find something to watch. And I started watching the Menendez brothers. And 961. This is 961. Okay. I'm gonna hold on to that one because 961 star. I started watching the Menendez brothers, And then I ended up, I forget what night this was, but I think I was alone Monday night. When did I start working on this project? I can't remember anymore, guys. I have no ideas. But on Monday night, Bob went to work, and I know I was too tired to come in here and do anything after I ate. So I went to the bedroom and I turned it on and I watched another episode. I watched like a couple episodes. And that, I don't know it didn't happen in New Jersey, but they're from New Jersey or something like that. And I know that they owned some kind of wing place in Princeton. I've eaten there. And they had really, like Chuck's Wings or something. I haven't gotten, if that's in the actual whatever, I haven't gotten to that. But that's, at least that's what I was told. Famous on the campus. Oh, that's right. They went to Princeton, right? Those kids, like one of them got kicked out. I don't know. Maybe it's before they killed their parents. I don't know if anyone's watched it. I'm not done. You know, I never talk details because I don't like to do spoilers. But a lot of people were commenting online about how awesome the actors were. Hold on a second. All right, sorry, Bob was leaving for work. Okay, so what are we doing here? We're doing 995, 996, and 3012 all on the same row. Okay, so 996. 995. Let's do 995. What is this? 939. We had to have done 939. I guess you go in here. New. Okay, so 995. This is 995. 995. Someone's coming back in the house.
Hi.
Oh, that's my daughter. You're home. You're home early. Okay, sorry, my daughter came home. So, I totally forget. I was talking about the Menendez brothers. Yeah, I'm not done. But, geez. Very interesting. And I couldn't help myself. Like, as I'm watching it, I'm Googling things. Like, I already know how it ends, you know what I mean? But like, I'm like Googling things that are happening in the show because I'm like, is that real? Like, did that really happen? Did that really happen? Like, I couldn't help myself. Most of the time I wait until it's over, but I was just like, I gotta know. So I've been watching that, and then I told you that Bob and I watched Deadpool and Wolverine, which was hilarious. But like, my days are basically, it's basically, so today I cleaned I didn't do any diamond painting. This is the first time I came into this room. Cleaned, showered, went to the gym, came home, took Moogie to the dog park. Now I can say the word because she's not in here. and then came home, cooked dinner for me and my son. Well, he helped me. Cooked dinner together. We had dinner together. Then we watched some TV. And then he left. And here I am. I'm still doing laundry, and I think most of my cleaning's done. It's just finishing up the laundry. And I want to vacuum my room. So, like, vacuum and dust. So that's basically, like, all every day. I didn't have to take her out this morning because Bob did it. Otherwise, normally I would have to take her out somewhere in the morning and then again in the evening. And she is, I mean, she has a lot of energy. And she needs a lot of playtime. I kind of understand why certain breeds, like shelters, want people to have a fence, because like she's a huge commitment, and I can see, like, I could see people getting a dog like her and then not wanting to exercise them the way they would need to be. Like, I could see that, because it's a lot and it's every day. I love her to death, so like I thoroughly enjoy seeing her run and exercise and, you know, just live her best life. And you know, she's so happy. She's just so happy when she's doing that. So like I was telling someone at work about it, and they were like, that's gonna get old, like you're not gonna want to do that all the time and blah blah blah. And I'm like, no, I don't mind. But you know, of course something has to give, right? Like I still only have so many hours in the day. That doesn't change. So unfortunately, that's why my videos are like sporadic. Because, like, today, I mean, listen, I'm, like, tired right now, but not like I have been. I've been so tired, and, there are nights where I go to bed at 9 o'clock. Monday night, I fell asleep on the couch before Bob left for work. And after he left for work, I got up, I made a bagel, and then I went into the bedroom and watched the show a little bit, and then I was out. 95, 96, 30, 12. And 33, 28 is when 3072, wow, look at this, is getting at least two, might get three. 3028, here's the next one, okay. I you get a star. And 3328 gets a star. So I'm just gonna go like that. All right, so 3031. Take two. Put this away. So yeah. Today I ordered a bunch of stuff from Amazon for the house. So I told Bob, I said, listen, I will have a lot of boxes coming. I said, but I want you to understand something. I was like, your wife does not like to go shopping. And so therefore, she has to do all of her shopping online. And so it looks like I'm buying a lot of stuff all the time. However, most wives go to like Target and spend $300, and then they go here and spend, you know, $200, and then they go. I said, your wife doesn't do that. Okay, so it might look like there's a lot coming into the house, but trust me, it's just things that we need. And I think you said something about like I should have been a lawyer or something. But, I mean, honestly, like, I got a new shower caddy for my shower. I was like, I had to get a new shower caddy. And he was like, why? And I said, it's rusting. And, like, there's pieces of rust falling off and into the tub. It's disgusting. And I don't want my stuff touching it. Like, it's grossing me out. And he was like, why would a shower caddy rust? I said, well, I've had it for like 4 years now. He's like, a shower caddy should never rust. And I'm like, well, it did. And it is. And I want a new one. So I ordered a new one. And then, guys, one of my biggest issues, please tell me if you can relate to this at all. Why is it so hard to find a good... I'm going to try to fit this. No. I'm not pushing it. Why is it so hard to find a good toothbrush holder? I mean, seriously. Why is that such a hard... I don't understand. So, I have hated every single toothbrush holder I've ever bought. You know, it's either, first of all, I don't like it when the toothbrushes touch. Like, they just shouldn't. I mean, it's just my daughter, but, like, why would you make a toothbrush holder where the toothbrushes touch? It just doesn't make sense. And then, half of them, the toothpaste tube doesn't fit in there. It's like... So when you go to pull it out, like the whole thing lifts up, or the last one I just bought. So it was the one that we had was round and it had like four spots and all this stuff. And it, like, every time I went to pull the toothpaste out, the whole thing came up, the whole unit. So I was at Walmart and I saw one that was like this, and I'm like, toothpaste is going to fit in there fine. Let me try this one. So I get that one. Well, when I get home, the top of it that has the separator was taped on. So I take the tape off and the freaking thing just falls apart. Every time I go to pull out the toothpaste, the whole top part comes off. And I'm just like, oh my God. I threw the other one out already. So I was like cleaning underneath my sink, and I saw just a white cup this tiny white cup that was supposed to be a toothbrush holder. I pulled that out and we're using that now. And so I was literally on Amazon looking at every single toothbrush holder, and I almost bought this one, and I went down to the reviews and I was watching a video, and it was like, it's a nice concept but falls apart. And I'm like, huh? And I watched the video, and it was exactly what the Walmart one was doing. I was like, oh my God, I almost bought another one. I would have screamed if I got that one. I would have been so angry. Ugh, why is it so hard? So the one I got, I'm praying, is good. Please, Lord, let this be good. Okay, so I did 30, 31. I have to come back to that. That's over here. I did 33, 28. So this is one. Okay. So it does not get. And then this one, how many does it have? Four. So I'm going to put a star here. And we're going to do three. 33, 63. 33. 63. Okay, 33, 63, 33, 64, 33, 63. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Put this away. Oh my gosh. Put these on backwards. Please come off easily. Yes. Yes. What do you guys have for your toothbrushes? I'm like, why is this so hard? Maybe I need to come up with, maybe that'll be how I become a millionaire. I don't know. So I have that coming. Hopefully it's everything I have ever dreamed of for my toothpaste and my toothbrush. And then I have like some pre-workout coming. I have on subscription razors, and every time it comes, I change out Bob's too. I have on subscription razors. On subscription. Oh, I had to buy more canned food for Noogs, so that's coming. Like, I haven't been. I usually just go to PetSmart with her, but I just don't think I have time to do that this week. And we literally have one can left, and it's beef. I'm convinced she's allergic to beef, so I just need to take that back to PetSmart and switch it for turkey or chicken. So I don't want to give her that. I mean, we have enough of the one can. It's going to be here tomorrow, so we won't run out. But so I have that coming. I mean, things that most people would be going to the store to buy, like, I do have coming to the house. Kitchen trash bags, I had on subscription. But we're not convinced that it's cheaper, so I canceled that subscription. Do you guys do any Amazon subscriptions? I have my toilet paper and my paper towels on subscription. My razors on subscription. What else? I think that's it right now. I used to have like my vitamins and stuff, but I don't have any of that on subscription anymore. You gotta be careful because you could end up putting everything on subscription. Oh, and I bought her a new harness. Because I was telling Bob I want to get her like a utility harness to make her look like a police dog. And I found one on Amazon, so I ordered it to see how it fits. I also got her a Raiders t-shirt for him. He doesn't know about it yet. So that's coming. All right, so we've done that first page. Guys, we're doing good. We're doing good here. Okay. And we did 3363. Okay. And how many more do we have? Okay. So now we're going to do 3364. And it's going to get a star. And that's going to share 3721. And that's this. And 3722 with a star, 3752, and then 3737. Oh no, 3787, 3799, and 3822. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I have 2, 2, and 2. And I'm going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so yeah, so this will be the end of this box. All right, so I think every one of these gets a star, right? 3064 star, 3721 star, 3722 star, 3750 star, 3752 star, 3787 star, 3799 star, 3822 star. Okay, so 3364. Oh my goodness. What you doing, girl? Is it that late? Is it that late? Moogie is like, she's getting into trouble out there. Moogie is 3364. Okay, let's find that one. That's this. 3364. So this is 1, 2. Moogie so gentle and sweet. Like, she does not play rough, guys, when she plays with other dogs. And she doesn't, like, bite at them or growl. I've never heard her growl or bite at another dog. And, she's staring at me. Let me let her in. You ready? Ready to come in here? Kaylee. So, I mean, and, like, they play rough with her, and they're, like, okay, there's this little lab who's a couple months older than her, because she got spayed at 6 months, and she got spayed a couple months before Noobs did. But she weighs less than Moody. We weighed her tonight, and we got her, we clocked her at 68.2 pounds. So she's almost 70 pounds. And I want to say that this lab is like maybe 45 pounds tops. This lab is pretty skinny. And the lab plays very rough, biting at her. She's not like growling, but she bites, and she like, she'll bite her. She bites her harness, her collar. She bites her like neck. And Moogie doesn't, well, she finally started to, but she mostly, like, just pushes her off and, like, tries to flip back up, and then, you know, she wants to chase and be chased and wrestle, like, but she doesn't ever, like, show her teeth or growl or bite at her. And I'm just like, she's like, I just think it's weird. Like, every other dog, I've never heard her growl or bark at another dog. Which, I mean, not bark. She has barked, like, to get them to, like, get their attention, to try to get them to chase her. But she, not maliciously, not like, you know, there's, the dog's like, they'll like snap at each other, like, or give like warning barks to each other. She never does that. She never ever does that. It's she's very, very in some instances she's very timid. Like, you know, if it's a larger dog, she'll, like, lay on her back and give her belly to them to show submissiveness. I don't know. Like, people keep saying, oh, wait till she's older, wait till she's older, she'll show them. But I don't see any signs of that. And, like, if the dog plays too rough with her, she doesn't growl at them. She'll like yelp to get them to get off of her. She'll cry. She's like such a, like a baby. I don't know. That's 3072, and I have the two over there. 3364 and 3721, and then I need 3371. Where's that? The other day I was at the dog park and there was a kid there, you know, just these parents brought their dog, their kid, and a very, very new baby, a brand new baby. And the mom was sitting on one of the benches feeding the baby, and the son was running around, and Mookie is not used to being around, you know, little people, kids. And so she started chasing him because, you know, he was about her size. He was probably like 8 or 9 or so. And I got nervous because, you know, I don't know if she caught up to him, if she would like nip at him. You know how dogs do when they're chasing something? I just said she's never nipped at a dog. She doesn't. But she nips at my husband, you know? And I said that to Bob. I'm like, well, how come she has no problem nipping at you and, you know, like, biting your arm and stuff when you guys are wrestling? But when she's wrestling with another dog, she doesn't ever bite at them. It's very weird. So I was nervous. I didn't know what she was going to do, you know. And, of course, he's got hands. I don't know, you know, if she caught up to him, if he would, like, push her away. And, I you know, you just don't know what the kid's going to do. You don't know. So I, like, ran after her and, like, grabbed her by the harness and was, like, telling her not to chase him, you know, and he kept running around. And after, he came over to where I was and he was talking, and I realized that, you know, he was, I believe he was like autistic. And he was trying to talk to me and tell me things. And, you know, he kept running around, and it was just making me nervous. Well, then Moogie, and the mom was sitting on a bench where it's like the first bench that you see at the dog park, and usually there's a dog owner. She's the mother of a dog named Pepper. Usually she sits in that very spot, and that's the first person that Moogie usually greets. I haven't seen her there this week. It's very bizarre, but this is the first time I haven't seen her all week, and so she wasn't there, but that's where this lady sat to feed her brand new spanking baby. Like, this baby was very young. And so Moogie goes, sees someone at the bench, and she starts running towards her. And I'm just like, oh, God. So I start running over there because I don't want her jumping on this lady's lap and, like, scratching this baby. Like, I'm just like, oh, my God. Like, you know, Moogie's a puppy. She doesn't know any better. But if anything happened, it would be my dog's fault, right? So I'm just, like, running over there. And I'm grabbing her, and she's like, oh, she was very, she's like sniffing the baby by the time I get there. And she's like, oh, she was very gentle. And I'm like, well, thank God. But I was just like, you know what? I got to go. So I left. I ended up leaving because I was just too nervous. It was just too stressful for me. You know, it's, I was like, I can't. And I don't know. I thought it was weird. I've never seen kids there before. It's like, some dogs don't even like kids. I don't know. Is it weird? I mean, I guess it's not weird. But man, I felt stressed. That was very stressful. Am I into this one? Did I really go through? What am I doing? 37.52. I feel like I emptied the bag. What do you guys think? I just left because I didn't want my dog to do anything and then, like, get in trouble for it. But she's, you know, she doesn't know all her manners yet. because she's a puppy, you know. So, I feel like the right thing to do was to leave, but I'm just curious, do you think it was weird that they brought their kids? I don't know, because, you know, an adult's not going to run and have strangers' dogs chasing them. Moogie was the only one that chased him, because like I said, I think she just didn't really know. Like, it was like a small human, and it was like, hey, he's my size. The other dogs couldn't care less. And then the kid was like, ow, you bit me. And I was like, who bit you? And he's like, my hound. And I was like, oh. I don't know if anyone else heard him say that. Like, he was, like, we were all around him. But I was just like, you know, I'm getting the hell out of here. Get my dog out of here. And there was a lot of dogs there at the time, too. Like, a lot. All the times I've been to a dog park, I've never seen a kid like that. I do see this lady who puts a baby, and Moogie loves playing with her dog. Her dog's name is Iger, and she puts the baby in a front pouch, and she carries the baby like that. And the first time I ran into this woman, I did get nervous that Moogie was going to jump on her, you know. She's pretty good about not jumping, but every once in a while she jumps on someone. Like, it's unexpected, and you know, but she's still learning. She's a puppy. She's pretty good. Like, most people that meet her, she'll sit down, because we try to teach her to sit when she meets someone new. And most people are like, wow, she's so good. She's sitting down. She's, you know, but every once in a while, you know, she's still learning. She'll jump. And I saw that lady and I'm like, oh God, please don't jump on her. And scratch that baby. I don't want to say it, but you know what's been better this round than last. I think I'm going to finish this kit up in this video, and this will be the last video. So a lot of people have been asking me about doing a video on how to order from AliExpress, and I want to keep referring you guys back to, I did do a video where I recorded on Bob's phone and all this. I'm wondering if, I can download AliExpress on here and show you guys. On there, because I want to make a video for you guys. I want to make a new video, but I really don't want to have to use Bob's phone if I can avoid it. Able to record on his phone, how I got the video onto my phone to edit it. I don't even know how I did that. Because you can't email videos, can you? I don't know. Let me see. Stickers, 3371, and what's the other one? 3072. Of course, they both get stars. All right, let's go to the store. Play Store, I think. Oh yeah, AliExpress. Okay. So I'll install it on this, and then I'll be able to show you guys on another video. Where's the brightness? There you go. That's better. All right, so it's installing. So I will make that video for you guys. Again, I do have a video about it, and I'll do an updated one, but in the meantime, maybe it's helpful. I've had several people comment on it that said it was helpful. If you want to check out my old video, it's under my playlists, and it's under, you know, my HAED playlist. It talks about how to order from AliExpress. And how you figure out what drills you need and all that, where you get that information. Oh my goodness. All right, we're gonna make a bunch of squares for these containers. Luckily, the static isn't to the point where I can't, you know, get it out of the bag, but it's enough where I think putting a small square in would be helpful so that when I finally go to use them, they'll lay nice in the tray. Oh my God. Literally picked all three of those up, and then this one has a foot. So it's trash anyway. All right. Where's my tweezers? Because they're not playing nice. All right. Let's put this big guy in here. Strip off. So, I mean, I've been so tired, guys. I've, like, by 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock at night, I'm having a hard time keeping my eyes open. But let me tell you, I slept, like I said to you, till 9 o'clock or whatever. I had so much energy today. That's why I started cleaning. I was like, oh, I am going to clean this and clean that. I'm going to organize this. Now, I want to redo my craft room. I want to reorganize and because my biggest problem is that I really don't know what to do with all of my finished diamond paintings. I feel like most people, like, they put them in a portfolio, which I have. I have a huge portfolio that I put my diamond paintings in. And then they, you know, they store it under a bed or somewhere, you know, where it can lay flat. I don't have anywhere. My house is so small. I don't have a spare bedroom. And my bed, in the middle of it, there's support beams that are blocking me from being able to slide a large portfolio under it. My daughter has storage, has a bunch of stuff stored under her bed. so I can't use under her bed. So what I currently have going on here is, now, so what I was doing was I took these huge foam poster boards and I taped them together and I put my diamond paintings in between them, and then I taped them together and I had it standing up behind my TV stand in my craft room. But when I took it out, they had slid down and, you know, they wrinkled. Luckily, none of them were damaged, but they wrinkled. And after laying flat, they flattened out. But I'm like, I'm not gonna do that again. So now I have this card table blocking the door to go outside. Every time we go to use the door to go outside, we have to move the card table out of the way. And I really don't know what to do with these diamond paintings. I don't, like, I have a garage, but it's not climate controlled. And I'm worried about, you know, it being 100 plus degrees out there and then being, you know, 20 degrees out there. Like, how are they going to hold up? I don't know. I don't know. So, I have, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So I don't know, guys. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to rearrange the furniture in here so that I can get this card table, like, out from in front of the door. And so we don't have to keep moving it every time we want to utilize the door to out back. You know, we just went and spent all this money to have a beautiful patio area. Now this thing is blocking us from getting to it. And I think part of the plan for that for me is getting rid of my TV, because I don't really watch it. And it's huge. It's like 55 inches. I don't really watch it. And I can't remember the last time I turned it on. And just eventually getting an iPad and just watching stuff on the iPad on my table if I want to watch Netflix or something like that. My son said he would take the TV. So then I would give him the TV, and then I can, I would get rid of this hutch. I don't know where I would put it though. It's not like I have anywhere else in my house, any room in my house for this hutch. And, and it's a gorgeous hutch from IKEA, so I don't want to throw it out. But ideally, I would get rid of it. and then I got rid of that. I could put another shelf in here. Because there are stuff, there is stuff inside, which I could easily organize in a different way. It's not a big deal. But, yeah, and then I would move this table. And I would move my desk out a little. Like, I would have to play with it. But, first of all, I would like to get my desk out from underneath the spotlight so that it wouldn't give me shadows. And I could record in both places at any time of the day without any issues with, you know, shadows and whatnot. So I would like to do that. And then... open up more room for this, because I would just leave the card table and use it as, you know, my diamond painting storage is my plan. All right, I need to cut up a bunch of these and put them in here. I don't know how does it seems like people have space for, you know, their finished projects, which I do not. This one is weird. Is that going to be a problem? All right, I want two more. So I'm just going to cut this whole strip. And we need the sticker, 3072. I'm gonna put that there. Right there. And we are done box four. All we have left, those colors. All right, let's do this. Okay, so we did 37.99 and 38.22. So we are up to here. All right, so first row would be 38.26. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'm wondering if I can give each one a row. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I'm just going to do it the way I've been doing it. So 38, 26, 38, 30. Okay, and they're all gonna have a star. This is the star box. Here's our last box. All right. I still have to do my month in review. Also, 38.26 and 38.30. Okay, so 38.26, we're gonna need two of these. It's funny. Soju, she shed way more than Ruby. Like, she shed so much. And I mean, her hair was everywhere. Everywhere. And Ruby sheds like a lot more than I was told. It's not everywhere, but it is all over my diamond paintings. Where Soju's hair, I mean, I would find it here and there, but it was not like Moog's. I think it's just because it's black, but like I have had to roll the back of my diamond paintings. And it's so funny because, you know, Soju's hair, she was a fawn pug, and I never saw it on the back of my diamond paintings. Maybe it is. Maybe a ton of my diamond paintings have her hair all over it. Never saw it. I never rolled one of my diamond paintings to get her hair off of it, but her hair was all over my clothes all the time. Like, I took her everywhere with me, everywhere, in ridiculous amounts. Like, I'm saying, I would take a kickboxing class and sweat, jump, kick, all this stuff for an hour. And then when we would get on down on the mat to stretch out, her hair would be falling off of me. And I'm just like, where is this coming from? Like, how is this even on me still? This is crazy, you know? This is supposed to be okay. I thought that this was okay. So 38, 34, and then 38, 35. I thought that that said 16 bags, but it's 6. 38, 34. But Moody's hair is never on my clothes. Like, I used to have to wait to put my scrubs on before I left for work. Like, it would be the last thing I did. Like, right before my alarm would go off, I'd go in the room and I'd put my scrubs clothes on and then I would leave. Like, I wouldn't put it on and then hang around. No, I would put it on and leave so that I wouldn't get her hair all over it. And I'd still sometimes would go to work and have to roll, like when I got to work, have to roll my pants out. If I sat down on the sofa, forget about it. I literally look like I rolled around in her bed. So I just never sat on the sofa. Like I would, if I did get dressed a couple minutes early, I would sit at the kitchen counter on one of the stools that she never had access to because she was like a foot tall. And yeah, I would sit there. And I still have that habit to this day. Like, I still forget that I can get changed early and I can sit on the couch and I won't have her hair all over me, Moogie's hair. Like, it's fine. I never have to roll my scrub close out or anything like that, but it's all over my diamond paintings. It's the weirdest thing. All over my diamond paintings. Like when I would wash our bedding when we had Soju, you know, the lint trap in my dryer, I mean, it would be full of her hair, full. Like a whole handful of her hair be coming out of that trap. Moogie's, I just did our bedding. Not very little. Very little. A little film of it. But my diamond paintings are filthy in the back now with her hair. It's so bizarre. I don't even understand it. With Soju, like, constantly, like, her hair would be, like, on your face, and you're constantly, like, rubbing her hair off of you. But none of that. It is such a weird thing. Now, I do take my diamond paintings and I put them on the ground to take photos a lot. 38, 37, and I'm sure that's a lot of where I'm sure that's where it's being picked up. And then it's so funny. It's like I've said this before, when I vacuum, I literally vacuum up like a Rottweiler puppy every time. So 38, 37, 38, 42. So she sheds, and like I could vacuum every single day and have to empty out a ton of her hair out of my vacuum. It's just all over the floor, I guess. And I vacuum multiple times a week. It's like I will vacuum one day after the other. I don't vacuum every day, but sometimes I vacuum. Like if I vacuumed today, I might vacuum tomorrow if I wake up and I feel like it needs to be vacuumed. Like I'm a little more OCD about it since I've had her because of how much hair I get up. But I just think it's so ironic how every once in a while I would see one of Soju's hairs like on my drill field, not on the sticky part, but like when I was done. I never had to put washi around my borders because it didn't get stuck there. But I'm constantly finding Moogie's hair on the glue around, you know, the edge of the border. It's so funny how different the hair is. But I could wear a white shirt and not have a single black rotty hair on it. So make of that whatever you want to. I don't know. Oops. That's one. We are almost done, guys. We have just four more colors. My daughter, I think, is putting away dishes, and that's what you hear. Well, that's what you are hearing. So I'm hoping that these nails last me through the weekend, and then next week I'll go ahead and try taking them off. So that's the process that I'm really not looking forward to. Putting them on actually wasn't bad. Boom. All right. All right, 38, 37, 38, 42. Gonna do 1, 2, 3. So I'm just gonna do a whole row for 38, 58. 1, 2, 3, 4. I stored the box of these next to my printer. And I wonder if that has anything to do with the static. And you notice, like, it seems like it's less. And I wonder if it's because it's been up on my table, like, not near. Oh, she's coming. Not near an electrical device. She's having a nightmare. Her paws are going. so funny, like, did I tell you guys that Bob told me when I left, she was like throwing her body against the door? I don't remember what I talk about anymore, especially when I do videos like days in a row. I have no idea what I talk about. She was upset because I left. I was telling my friend, I was like, she is probably like, oh my God, she's going to the dog park without me. Like, because where else does she think I'm going? But she's starting to understand, like, when I put my scrubs on, she knows that I'm leaving, like, and she probably knows I'm not coming back. And now when I carry my water bottle, because I use the same water bottle to go to the gym, when I grabbed my water bottle today, she didn't try to follow me. She just watched me leave. And I swear it's because she knew that I wasn't going to take her with me. Oh my God. Okay. Let me get some. It's not too bad. It's just too big. Gotta get some more. I want to, what I could do is, like, take a spare row or two and do two more rows of 310, and move, like, just move the boxes, move our colors down each box. I might do that, or maybe I'll just make a whole side 310 if I have room. No, I won't. I might add more 310 to the end, because if there's 35,000, then I might be going through it a lot. And I might have to, like, if I just have two rows of it, I might be having to stop and refill those two rows a lot. Or I could just swap them out from the back side. Because there's 35,000 310s. See me trying to rub it. All right. She's snoring. One, two, three, 3860. $38.62 gets a whole row. I feel like I might as well just do two. I need two for the next color. Lovely. So I live in a retirement neighborhood and we literally get no trick. I feel like, is it against the rules here? Because we don't get any trick-or-treaters. You would think, our first year Bob got candy. It makes sense. Like, honestly, I thought that because people bring their kids to the pool, their grandkids and stuff, and I just thought it would, like, they would think it was a safe place to go trick-or-treating. But then again, it's like, you know, you're asking the elderly to come to the door and open it for people they don't know. And yeah. Yeah, it's probably frowned upon. So we do not. Honestly, I'm going to be honest with you. Trick or treating, like, doing that, opening the door, I always made Bob do it because I'm not that kind of person. Can anyone else relate to this? Like, I get him, like, I'm not like, oh my god, you're such a cute witch. And like, I'm just not like that. Like, I'm all shy and like, here, take a candy. And then I'm always like, you can take another, like, oh, you can have another. Do you want another? Do you want another? But, like, my shyness, yeah, makes me so awkward that I get embarrassed. I don't know. So I always make Bob answer the door. And, you know, he's great at it because he was a martial arts instructor. He taught kids for years. And he would be real loud and, oh, like, so I think he actually liked it. You know, he would have Halloween parties at his school and stuff, so. I would just let him do it. All right. 38.63. And then we're done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. Hey, there's no white in this. No 5200. Just noticed that. Oh, let me take a sip of my coffee. We're almost done. Anybody else like awkward like that? So shy. No, I've always been like that. I remember watching The Voice and Miley Cyrus was like, I don't have a shy bone in my body. Honestly, I think I'd rather not have a shy bone in my body than be as shy as I am. I've gotten better though. Like, this is the best I've been when it comes to, oh my God, I just try to put it in this one and it's closed. This is the best I've been when it comes to like being shy. This color has a lot. I don't know why certain colors, like they were all in the same bag, but this one seems to have, I was pouring all those other ones and they weren't bad. This one is definitely worse than all the other ones. Strips for this color. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, I have a Christmas project idea. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about it. I'm, you know, going back and forth on how elaborate I want to make this. And I said that I was probably not going to do one, because I spent a lot of time, money, and effort into these videos, and they don't get a lot of views. But honestly, it's not always about the views. You know, I do know some people enjoy them. And I don't know, I like making it fun, doing something different, and being creative. So, you know, I decided that I was going to do something. I just hope that, of course, I'm probably going to bite off more than I can chew because that's just who I am and I don't know how to be anybody else. So if I did, who would I be? I'd be PewDiePie. Yeah, so I started kind of figuring that out. I've been thinking on exactly how I'm going to execute this. Going back and forth, and yeah, I think think it's going to be fun. Like gremlins, they just keep multiplying. There. All right, I'm gonna swish this around. See if I can avoid. It's been working pretty well with my finger. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm almost done. Tomorrow, Movie's gonna be in daycare. She's gonna get her nails trimmed. So I'm thinking I'll be able to start this tomorrow. And what we'll do is we'll do the first square together, but you're probably gonna have to wait for these videos are probably gonna come out not right away because I have to do my month in review and it's already October 2nd. And I just have some videos that I have to put out first. So, but They'll be out. Okay. Now, I'm not going to do it with you guys, but I think I'm going to fill these up with 310. Because, or maybe I won't, and I'll just see. I'm just going to throw all this out. These are all old. Maybe I'll just see how often I'm using the 310s. So these are my boxes. I have 5 rows left. Wow, I forgot how heavy they are when they're all full. So these are my 5 boxes. I'm so excited. And I'll show you how many drills I have left over. Hold on. Yeah. That's what we're looking at. Oh my goodness. All right, guys. That is all I have for you. So there's lots of content to look forward to. If you haven't already, consider subscribing. It's free. And you can watch me and follow along on my journey as I diamond paint this massive project along with other projects. And then I plan on doing something for Christmas. And yeah, I have a lot of stuff to do. I'll show you guys how to order from AliExpress and we'll do the first. I'll do my first square of this with you so I can show you how I use Pattern Keeper and all of those things. I haven't used Pattern Keeper in a hot minute. So over a year, maybe two, I don't know. Now, how long have I even been doing this craft? I don't even know. What year is it? But so, you know, I might be doing a little learning curve again and getting some kinks out, and we can do that together. But yeah, that is all I have for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed all the Kit Up videos. And I hope you come back. And if you liked this video, if you wouldn't mind giving me a thumbs up on the way out. And again, if you want to see more from me and see me complete this, it's going to take a long time. But if you want to watch me along my journey, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join the family and friends here at Kimbaskrafts. I would love to have you. You guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Take care. Keep diamond painting.